Hey there, the Geeky Minecrafter here, bringing you another episode. Today is the long-awaited episode where we build an XP farm. Now we'll be using giant portals, we'll be capturing zombie pigmen, and we'll be flowing them down into a kill pit where we're going to crush them. This is going to allow us to get the XP as well as the gold. So if you're ready, come on, let's get started. Now, here's what I've done so far. I've made a couple of trips out to the area that I've selected. I have taken a few chests. I have carried some, no obsidian, some cobblestone, stuff like that. A couple of tools. I am gathering up, I came back to gather up some more resources. I'm going to take a bow and leave it. I'm going to take some arrows and leave it. I've made a bunch of torches, and I'm carrying pretty much all of the obsidian that I have collected. Now I do have some more, but I'm gonna refill those stacks. So I believe it's going to take. Let's see, the portals can be 23 by 23. That's the max. I'm gonna do four portals on the outside, four portals on the inside. Four blocks smaller, so whatever the math is on that, I'll stop and figure it out once we get over there. Let's get away from all these noisy animals. Okay, so I've decided to go way over there. There's some hills. So one of the things I've done is I've lit it up on the way over. I've made a bridge here. Now, I haven't done all of it. Again, I've only made a couple of trips, and you know it takes a while to build out your path. Here, let me go ahead and get that there. Where it goes. Okay, so I'm probably going to chop down a couple of trees on the way, but you know, every time I come by, I do a little bit of thinning. As you can see, this is a pretty thick forest. So I've got quite a bit of thinning left to do, as you can see. This design, I'm not entirely sure who started it. I know that Mumbo built one. I know that Tango Tech has done something similar. So I'm going to be, you know what, I need some stairs, but we'll just go this way for now. I put that torch up there to let me know, you know, this is where I came over. Now, also, I filled this in, but right under these four torches, there is a giant shaft that heads straight down, and it's kind of scary in there. I see a bunch of resources. I will probably come back out and mine it. That's why I marked it. But this is the area that I've selected right over here. I think it's going to give us, you know, a wide open view all the way around. I'm going to build it, of course, up into the air. I'm going to build part of it down into the ground. And so I'm just thinking I like this little area. One of the things you want to do is you want to be far enough away that no entities are really kind of messing with you. I'll show you what I have all around. I have forest. I have extreme hills. I have canopied forest. I have snow biome over there. I have an iced biome way out that way, you know, one of those ice spears. So this is the area that I'm going to start building in. So let's lay off this obsidian. Put this up. We're not quite ready to start with that. I do want to do a little bit of marking, kind of staking it out, if you will. Let's see. We'll put emergency torches there. We'll do a bow. This is my unbreaking. Add some more chicken. Again, I've just been bringing over the resources that I think I'm going to need to build this. Now, I'll use the axe on the way back. Knock down a few of those trees. So I think I want to take all this down one level so it's kind of even. And it looks like the majority of it. You know what? I tell you what, let's use the silk touch. And can grab some of this right over here. I'm trying to think, you know, where it will be less impactful to pull some of this stuff away. Oh, you gotta love a silk touch with efficiency 5. That's right, it's a one-hit wonder. 17. Maybe I can do something with this, some kind of, you know, little cabin built into the side of the hill or something. I don't know. I hate completely reorganizing and re-terracing the land around here, but this is going to be pretty good size. So let's just grab a little bit more of this. All this stuff. Okay, so like I said, I think what I'm going to do is right in here, I'm just going to kind of finish filling this in. Oh, that's not the stone. Goodness. You know, we should probably do a little bit of counting here. Oh, good grief. I know that I need 23 by 23. For the outside edge. Well, okay, to be clear, 23 by 23 is the max I can have. I actually considered 20 by 20. Now, I think there are reasons for going as many wide as you can. The predominant reason is that the zombie pigmen's spawn rate is controlled by how many portal blocks you have. Now, I'm not talking about the portal blocks that go around the outside. I'm talking about the blocks within the center. So when you build the frame, okay, on a normal portal, for example, that's 2 by 3, right? So 2 times 3, you've got 6. So you've got 6 portal blocks that control the spawn rate. With a 20 by 20, you've got 20 times 20, which is 400, right? You get 4 of those, you've got 1600. You get the interior ones. You see what I'm going for here. The more you have of those interior portal blocks, the more likely you are to spawn a pigment. So that's one of the things we want to do is increase our square footage, if you will, for where we spawn the pigment. Okay, I'm just gonna do a real quick count here. From here, let's say if we fill it in from here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, so that's the width. I'm actually going to make it a little bit bigger. But that's the minimum that I'm thinking I want to have. So we'll do this. Maybe 2 on either side of it. We want to go 20 wide as well. Okay, so if you follow my channel, my YouTube channel, you know that I've begun trying Twitch and that I'm having serious technical difficulties. I'm going to reach out. Oh, you know, I shouldn't cover that out. Let's change out. Get the other pick. Hate covering up coal, you know, because, gosh, it's not like this stuff grows on trees. Let's go ahead and get this. I also need the experience points, just to be clear. What was I saying? Oh, I'm having technical difficulties. I've been using OBS software. That's the broadcasting software. It's what allows you to, you know, have multiple scenes, one scene being Minecraft, one scene being a be right back message. So in the event you have to walk away and minimize Minecraft. I'm trying to think of, what program it is I use. But I'm having some problems with the OpenGL stuff. It's not allowing me to record without interruption. I get lockups. OpenGL will crash, and then I've got. We're just gonna cover this up. I don't care about that. So I'm. This is a call for help. I guess is really what it boils down to. I went and got XSplit software. I've been trying that out, and although I was able to record a little bit longer, I'm still having problems. My OpenGL just does not want to cooperate. You know what? I'm lit up, but it's technically dark. Let's go ahead and do this before they get close. Oh yeah. Boy, there was a time, like when I started Minecraft, that there was no way in heck I was going to sleep outside like that. Isn't it funny what diamond armor and a little bit of experience will do for you? So anyway, if you know about XSplit, or you know about OBS, or you know about OpenGL, or the NVIDIA GeForce drives, video drivers, I'd love to hear from you. I'm struggling. I always tell people, I'm a geek, but I'm not a hardware guy or, gal. I always, when I worked in the corporate workplace, I had people on staff that handled the hardware. That's just not my job. Okay. Let's take the last of this up. Okay. Oh, I need to go get a little more stone. Do I? No. Here we go. Oh, it also looks like I'm getting hungry here. So let's mow down. Gosh, he's so rude, just burping right at the end like that. We ladies, we have to be polite. We don't have to burp like that. That's just crazy. Okay, that looks pretty good. So we decided this was 20, right? So I do need a bit more stone. Let's go ahead and take the rest of this down a little bit. Okay, and I promise, after I get this kind of leveled off and flat, we will go ahead and mark out the boundaries. I'll probably use dirt or cobblestone to do that. And then I'll replace it. Now, I did bring enough wood that I'll be able to build a crafting table. I'm going to need some ladders because, this is survival mode. I can't fly. And these are going to be pretty tall. They're going to be 23 tall. So we're definitely going to want to get some ladders so we can get up and down comfortably. I know there are people that are looking at me using this silk touch to pull this stone out and thinking I'm just nuts. And you're probably right. I should be saving this for the glowstone. It's taken me long enough to get another silk touch. Seems like every time I get close to having enough levels, some zombie would come along or some creeper would come along. So I decided to quit messing around with the iron armor. And I just... went ahead and built myself some all-diamond armor, and I don't have it enchanted yet, but it is so far doing a pretty good job of, keeping me protected. It's looking pretty good. So let's, these last couple of rows here. Okay, so we decided this is 20, right? So this is 21, 22. And do we go one this way? We did. Okay. So I'm going to get rid of these torches because I want to create my boundaries. Oh, hello. Okay, so once again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10 is the center point. Or no, 11 is the center point. 12, 13, 14, 15, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. I think we're going to do that. 22 by 22. So... Did I do that right? I miscounted. 1, 2, 3. I'm going the wrong direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, 11. Wow. That's pretty close. I'm going to have to move my bed, but I'm okay with that. Okay, so these are the borders. As a matter of fact, let me do these. So we're going to go like this. I don't have any cobble, really. Good grief. I brought some over. I am prepared. Other than I don't have my my ladders built. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, oh, good grief. So these are the borders. Now, they're actually going to go up, not around. I'm just building my lip. This is where the water's going to be. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Is that in line? It sure is. Beautiful. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Right there. Does that line up? Yep. Okay, so let's go build some ladders. I only brought one water, didn't I? Dadgummit, but I have an empty bucket. Where do I have some water? I want to build an infinite water stream so that I can... put a couple of these. Oh, do I not have water right here? There we go. Gotta come down into this forest canopy. Ouch. Just look around, make sure there's no googlies in here. Nobody wants to eat my face off. Dang zombies. Okay, let's get back up there. I maybe didn't think this all the way through, huh? Huh. Can you do this? Why, yes, you can. You see cobblestone running around out in the trees. What is this about? That works. Okay, so I'm going to be building up. So one of the things I want to do is near this, where I can aim for it, I want to have a place where I can throw some water down, create an infinite water source, so I have something to aim for. Because we all know... I am not the most graceful. Okay. So the build calls for the obsidian to start 4 blocks above where you're going to have the water flowing. So I'm going to flow the water here. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, the obsidian is going to go right on top of that. And it looks like I need to get set up for that. Go ahead and get my ladders. Now I'll knock these blocks out when I'm done. Let's see, we'll put some stone in there. It might not be a bad idea to have some dirt scaffolding. Put some of these torches up so I have room. Let's see, we need some wood to make some ladders. And apparently a crafting bench. You know what, these are right next to this. Should I move those over? Can I sleep yet? Nope. I have the room over here, don't I? Yeah, I think I am. I think I'm just going to move everything over by 3. That way I've got the room. I don't have to move everything I've already got set up. Maybe just 2. Can I sleep yet? Come on. I don't really snore. Okay. All right. So, 1, 2, 3. I know. Boring, right? Oh, I miscounted. I think it's that one. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. Oh. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nope, I missed it. 11. I should set these down. 2, 3. Yeah. Yeah, I want to go ahead and get this moved now before I start building that. That would just bite. Let's put that back. 1, 2, 3. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Appreciate your patience. I did mention I'm anal retentive, right? Oh, that means my water needs to move. Dadgummit. Okay, let's go build that crafting table and the ladders now. So, need some planks. With my planks, make a crafting table. Let's just set that right there. Okay. That's enough sticks. Let's start building some ladders. I need 20. Oh, what's going on here? Okay, that should do it. And did I pick up the obsidian? No? Okay, let's put some sticks back for right now. Oh, I wish somebody would tell me that little trick that they do where you pick this up and you, I don't know, you click something. Oh, it's a double click. Sweet. Okay. So four high, that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, that is right next to there. Okay. Let's put the obsidian in the hot bar. And I'm going to be up here. I probably am not going to need, not going to need my sword. Okay. I'm sorry. The next part here is going to be just an awful lot of counting, and I apologize in advance for that. Okay, you ready? Can I tell you? A little scattered today. It's Sunday. Cannot be good. Sorry for going so slow. I just have to sneak. I do not have the best luck when it comes to... Wow. That was close. They are going to be able to share the frame, right? I'm going to be able to ignite inside here and inside here. Boy, I surely do hope so. Would really, really bite. Oh, wrong key. Good grief. To get all this done and not have it ignite. Oh, come on. So that's all four corners, all four pieces, all four. Now, got to do the same thing inside. There's concentric rings. So this one's 22. The interior one will be two blocks smaller. The interior one inside of that will be two blocks smaller. So let's jump down here before it gets way dark. Oof. Let's hit the bed. Okay, looky who's coming. Looky who's coming to visit. Set me on fire, are you kidding me? Okay, so maybe that's not the right sword to use with zombies. Yeah, fire aspect. Did I bring my other one? Here, what's that one? Smite 2. Yeah, I think for zombies we're gonna stick with this one. Okay. So let's see. I do need iron and I need flint. And there's a good possibility. Don't I have some gravel right around here? I covered it up, didn't I? Okay, actually, you know what? It's not that fast a trip. I will speed through this. I'll be right back. You guys, this has been quite a long episode, and perhaps what we should do, let's get back out there before it gets dark. Perhaps what we should do is call it at this point. Now I've got we'll just call this part one. I've got quite a bit of work to do. I've got to get the area where they're going to flow into. I got to keep them from being able to escape, so I need to wall it in. And although I may wall it in with glass, which means I've got to go find a desert because I don't have very much sand. I'm gonna need some cactuses. Or no, I decided to do the crusher, didn't I? So we'll need a couple sticky pistons, like 4 maybe. 4, 8, somewhere in there. And some redstone. Yeah, I'm just trying to think of what else we need here. Probably should have thought of that before I ran all the way back over here. Okay, let's see. We gotta know if it's gonna ignite, right? I gotta know. Okay, let's go ahead and get the water on here too. Because if it ignites, I'm gonna turn it right back off. So wait! Okay. There we go. So let's just make sure this side over here ignites. You know, I'm sure that it will. If one does, they all will, right? Yep. Okay, so that's it. They're all going to ignite. Now I've got additional rings that are going to go inside here. I mentioned come in 2, 1, 2. So I'll have a ring here, right? 2 between them, yep. So I'll have a ring here, on and on and on, all the way around. So I think we're gonna call it. We'll do this. We'll put this in the background with the cow. Here, moo cow. Hello? No? Okay, this is the Geeky Minecrafter. I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, smash that like button. Really does help me and my channel out. If you just want to be notified when I put a new video up, do the subscription. Let your friends know. I'm streaming on Twitch TV as Minecraft Gran, G-R-A-N, Gran. And I look forward to hearing from you. Check out the channel, check out the stream, and I'll be live. You can ask questions. I'll put it together what you want. So till next time, this is the Geeky Minecrafter signing out. Happy mining!